Few phones have arrived with as much fanfare as the Samsung Galaxy S4. But does this quad-core full HD smarter than smartphone really live up to all the hype? Well, design-wise, we're not sure there was much hype there to begin with. The Galaxy S3 was a decent-looking phone, and the S4 crams more in less space, but it isn't exactly premium. It's pure plastic, complete with bendy back cover and faux chrome trimmings. So it's not particularly rich in the hand. Having said that, it is quite light and it does fit well in the pocket. The S4's 5-inch Super AMOLED screen is a beauty. It looks mesmerizing with bold, saturated colors and a PPI of 441. Pictures look crisp, text nice and sharp. The user interface is a point of both adoration and contention. On the one hand, the Galaxy S4 runs Android 4.2, the latest version of Jelly Bean, which is great. It's also loaded with a host of apps and smart features out of the box. These include the fantastic AirView, registering a hover as an input, previewing elements of the user interface. S Plan is also incredible, with its application and the respective calendar widget offering the best looking calendar integration on Android, while Group Play can turn multiple S4s into a collective of surround sound speakers. Sounds great, right? But on the other hand, the Galaxy S4 interface goes a step beyond being too heavy. It's crammed with features, and between the over-the-top lock screen customizations through to the ridiculous 20 toggles in the notification bar, it's just plain confusing at times. What's more, the phone stutters every now and then. Not something we'd expect from a quad-core phone, let alone the most powerful quad-core phone on the market. The 13-megapixel camera on the Samsung Galaxy S4 is the same sensor as found on the Sony Xperia Z, though the results are very different. In good lighting, it delivers amongst the best shots out there, stacked with detail, vibrant colors, and good exposure levels. Low light, however, is the S4's main weak point in automatic mode. Flip it into night mode and things do get better, and the flash really is an excellent performer, but with no flash, you're gonna get a lot of grain. There are also plenty of shooting modes, such as dual shot, which simultaneously takes a picture of the photographer and the subject. You've also got something called animated photo, and it's a smart GIF creator, so you can get very, very BuzzFeedy with your Galaxy S4. Videos are recorded at full HD and deliver the same strengths and weaknesses as the photographs, with strong detail and picture quality in bright daylight, but mediocre results as dusk dawns. For some full-size samples and the full review, make sure to check out Rekombu.com. Perhaps more impressive is enjoying media on the Galaxy S4. The big, bright, bold screen is perfect for full HD movies, and at 5 inches you have ample space to enjoy them on. Reading on it is a pleasure. Music is perhaps a weakest point though, given the phone's single rear-facing speaker, which is easy to cover up and muffle. It is better than the Sony Xperia Z, but it absolutely pales in comparison to the HTC One. With the cheapest Galaxy S4 costing £579 offline and packing 16 GB, we don't even want to think about the price of the 32 and 64 GB versions. It's expandable by up to 64 GB via microSD card though, so unless you're an app hoarder or a gamer who needs shed loads of onboard storage, 16 GB should be ample. When it comes to connections, the S4 has it all, and the kitchen sink. It's got Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, 3G, 4G, NFC, S-Beam, GPS, you won't be left wanting. Thanks to the ample screen, web browsing is also a treat, with sharp text and smooth panning and swiping. The stock browser even incorporates AirView, magnifying pages when you hover your finger over them. Speaking of smooth panning and swiping, performance from the 1.9 GHz Qualcomm Snapdragon 600 processor should be stellar, and most of the time it is. The phone benchmarks like a champ and plays games back flawlessly. What isn't so great though is that the user interface stutters. This baffled us initially. We soon realized turning off the abundance of smart features remedied this. What does this mean? TouchWiz is too heavy, far too heavy. battery life is fantastic, easily lasting a full day thanks to the 2600 milliamp battery inside. It's the best of the current flagship Android bunch, with the HTC One just behind and the Sony Xperia Z falling in third in the battery stakes. Is it the best of the three though in general? In many ways, yes. It's smarter, it's more powerful, and it'll last longer than the other three. But we can't help feel that both the user interface and the body lack the finesse of the HTC One, and it isn't water resistant like the Xperia Z. Still, the S4 is a safe bet, a great smartphone, and a worthy successor to the Samsung Galaxy S3.